وحب عمل صالح يقربنا إلى حبك. Oh Allah, give us the ni'mah of your love. Guide us to love you, it's the best ni'mah. And also to love the one you love him. If the believers, oh Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, give us the ability to love the believers. Because we must love the believers. If Allah loves some, you have to love it. وَحُبَّ عَمَلٍ صَالِحٍ يُقَرِّبُنَا إِلَىٰ حُبِّهِ. Allah guide us to love the action you love. If you love the prayer, let us love the prayer. Not only pray, but love the prayers. If Allah tabarak wa ta'ala loves us, loves the charity, guide us to not to spend only, but to love to spend, to love the charity. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala loves fasting, guide us to love the ibadah, the worship, because the most important thing in ibadah, to do it with love. Because two things to Allah, you cannot do it for anyone but for Allah. كمال الحب مع كمال الخضوع. Unlimited love for Allah, but in the same time, unlimited, this word, inshallah, if you dislike, we can find another word for translation. Unlimited love with unlimited humiliation to Allah. مع كمال الذل والخضوع. The humiliation only for Allah. And this is not bad word when we talk about, the relationship between the servant and Allah is not bad word. It's the best word. Dhul. And Allah mentioned that in the Quran. Allah talked about Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and his companions in the battle of Badr. He said, وَلَقَدْ نَصَرَكُمُ اللَّهُ بِبَدْرٍ وَأَنْتُمْ أَذِلَّةٌ وَأَنْتُمْ أَذِلَّةٌ. Allah gave you the victory in Badr while you were humiliated, azilla, seeking help from Allah. We are nothing without your help. So that's the main thing. So then, when we talk about ibadah like the prayer, we have to also, يعني, to connect this topic with the Quran and the Sunnah. Otherwise, that's the best way. Not the best way to give a lecture. Not the best way to talk. The best way to affect by this verses and this hadith, because that is the main one. Can it change your heart? It's the Quran and the Sunnah. When we say Allah talk about the Salah such and such, that's Allah, not some scholar said about the Salah. When we say the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, either he talk about the Salah or how he prayed. So it's also something you have to think about it. That's the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Don't be that. And what about us? So let us start with that, inshallah. Sallu ala Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. In the beginning, how many pillars of Islam?
Five.
The first one? The first one?
Shahad.
Shahad. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. They said this pillar, it's not action, it's not practical pillar. It's the gate, to open the gate, to come to Islam. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله. That's the gate opened now. And then, that's it. When this word started in Islam, from the first day of Islam, اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. Then what happened? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم went to Khadija. Khadija, yes. Okay. Allah chose me to be the last prophet. So what she has to say? أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله و Muhammadan Rasulullah. That's it again. Then what? After that, what? When started?
In Medina.
10 years after, no. In Mecca. In 10 years after, that's still in Mecca. In the night of Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, that's before Hijra. 3 years before Hijra. Then, that's the Salat. It was the first pillar. The first practical pillar Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala make it obligatory to do. You have to do. That's the first one. As-Salat. Remember that. Then all of the pillars after that. Zakah, fasting, Hajj. That's became obligatory in Al-Madinah. The second year, Zakah and fasting and Zakah. In the second year. In the year number 6 or number 9, based on the difference between some scholar, they verified that. They said either 6 or 9, Allah make the Hajj obligatory. So it means the Salah is the first one. Then, focus this hadith. The last, you can say the last what? The last halaqa, the last hook in the chain of Islam will be broken, it's As-Salah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that the Islam like chain between us and the Allah, chain. Then, what is the name of the halaqa? Each one?
Hook
also?
Ring.
Ring.
Ring. Maybe ring much better. Okay. It's because ring, we need this ring. What is this ring?
Links.
Huh?
Link.
Linking rings and
ring. Linking ring. Yeah. Linking. Okay. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that Islam completed in the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Right? Then, day after day, one link of Islam will go. The people, they will destroy one. God, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, لَتُنْقَضَنَّ عُرَى الْإِسْلَامِ عُرْوَةً عُرْوَةً أَوَّلُهَا نَقْطًا الْحُكْمُ. The first one to be removed, which one? Which one to go first?
Zakat.
No. See, Prophet, the Prophet Muhammad told us, we do not know, but until he told us. So, and then we cannot just even give us يعني, a chance to think, just to listen to him. Easy way to يعني, go forward. Simple. What's the first word of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He said, Al-Hukm. The Hakim of Muslimin does not apply the Sharia of Allah. Let's start. How long time started?
Long time.
Long time. That's the first one. Then, after that, count after that, many by after that. The Prophet he mentioned the first one and the last one. But he did not mention between, because between, it's many. Many. Some people, they stop giving zakah. Some people, they stop fasting. Some people, they stay away. They commit big sins. It's easy. Some of them, they stop wearing hijab. Some of them, they do not care about the haram or halal. So that's many stuff. Then the last one, if gone, this will be before the day of judgment.
That is salat.
وَآخِرُهَا نَقْضًا. That's the last one. The last ring. No more chain. Just ring. That's the last one. As-salah. If the salah gone, the people they do not pray, then Allah doesn't need this universe. Universe must go. خلاص. This is the hadith of Prophet Muhammad. So the first